As GOUP, we did not award anyone this year, nor did we deserve it. The reason is that we have not been able to come up with ambitious work aimed at the goals or results that we had in mind. Our 50th webinar has also been postponed until next year. On the contrary, I would say that our commitment figures are down from previous years, but fair enough for the time we put in. Looking at the follower list, our reputation in the foreign market has increased. As for the main reasons, it was me. About the project. In order for the project to be sustainable, it is necessary to create value along with generating income, so as not to be exhausted by boring work. We need a well-automated product and process. Smaller but experienced leading team. The success of the event can be measured by strong partners, sponsors, and organizers. My personal excuses. I paid attention to the community formed after the Y Combinator Startup School. There were interesting acquaintances, collaborations, and next year we should try to make it on a larger scale. I made friends with a solid engineering community at Hacker Dojo, and we had 4 meetings there. I took a step back and questioned everything I did. As they say, same input, same output applies. Different inputs are required. There were many distractions: the war, the market, or COVID. The potential of artificial intelligence was amazing. We will try to be on top of this game next year. I have finally found my mission. Knowing my limits, I will invest my time in the short and long-term ultimate success of a mission that creates value for others while maintaining my own happiness. As a result, it is necessary to pay attention to 3 indicators for the longevity, sustainability, and scalability of the project. 1. Financial capital. Creating paid value. Becoming more knowledgeable about finance/tax/law and startups. Keeping in mind cost and revenue metrics. 2. Intellectual capital. Knowing how to build a healthy process, manage, delegate, then scale. Strong team and culture. 3. Social capital. Various people and community meetings. Trust. Market reputation. Fair play. But if you ask who I want to thank: Mohammadiyah Abdurahimov, Rahimli Rahim Sevi Boaver, and newcomers Elchin Mamadov and Gaya Jalilov for their continued work to bring together nearly 100 tech communities in the United States. Vergen Hajiev and Orkan Husainli Ismail Mamadov for organizing the Tech Brains event in Baku. We were planning to do it for our friends in Europe, but our workforce did not allow it. There are also quite strong engineers there. I hope they will come together this year. Timur Hajiev for writing a rather complex product for universities. Bravo to our technical schools and their teams: Farhad Karimov, Pashabeli, Fuad Razim Abdullayev, Mervari Medieva, Imran Yusubov, Ruslan Ramazanov, Amangiliev, Ms. Aiden Gap/opportunity. If you have a conversation about open source, it can be done even at a small level. Media: Jamil Husinzade from tech.az, Bekhtiar Hazanov from tadroid.com. Vacancy/opportunity. I think there is more demand for this type of content. My general observations. Most of the individual friends writing from Baku are interested in remote and full-time jobs in Europe and the USA. Gap/opportunity, a research team is needed to make this transition. Most local companies writing from Baku have competence and enthusiasm, just need cloud and foreign experience. I love you all and Happy New Year!